And Nilesh Awate, research scholar, Department of Mechanical Engineering, delivered a PhD pre-submission seminar on design and development of mobile crop residue disintegrator. Next. A background information. In India, nearly 76% of population live in rural area, out of which 69% depend on the agriculture for livelihood. A real breakthrough is productivity and increasing the social activities is expected to improve with time to extensive application of mechanization in Indian farm. Cotton, sorghum and pulses are the major crop of Vidarbha region of Maharashtra state. The huge available biomass left in the field after harvesting is having nutrient value in it. A GHRCE study revealed that the cotton crop in the region of Vidarbha alone produce about 2.5 to 6 ton of waste per hour per hectare. Potential of biomass in India. Availability of national biomass atlas generated by Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, for agro residue. According to Typex survey of major 14 crops, there are about 623.4 million metric tons biomass residues available. Currently available data show that around 500 million tons of residue was produced in the country during 2006 and 2007. Around 220 million tons of biomass are used as a fuel as a household, like chulas and other. If we have increased the efficiency of this stove by 10%, next. The surplus amount of biomass are available 100 to 110 million tons, and added surplus 15 to 20% normal surplus, it become 150 to 160 million tons per year. This would be sufficient for sustaining 60,000 to 80,000 megawatt power generated capacity with the plant load factor of 60 to 80% as reported by Terry. Over the last 2.5 decades, biomass power has become an industry sector attracting annual investment of over 4,000 crore. The sector generated more than 700 crore units of electricity and creates employment opportunity of more than 50 million man's day in rural area. Biomass for manufacturing of the consumer product. One more way where the agriculture crop residue can be used gainfully in the form of raw material for manufacturing particle boards. Being superior to nutrient wood in terms of availability and cost, this product are becoming increasingly popular in the India. Little attention is paid, however, to collection of the widely scattered and stew stream fragmented in the field owing to high cost of labor, as also that the transporting and loosely packed stack to the place of shredding to consumption. A ready availability of the low-cost operationally efficient machines in the field would reduce the several post-harvesting hassles concerning the agro-waste. Another matter of great convenience would be that the shredded chip can be packed into container or cloth bag, the field itself, and then transported to the product manufacturing of the point of application in ready-to-use form. The biomass processing equipment. The Akola and Yavatmal region is the major hub of cotton in the Maharashtra. After harvesting this crop, huge amount of crop residue remain in the field and possess difficulty to farmer for the further cultivation. The rigorous work has been carried out Dr. Panjabrao Deshmukh Kushit David Akola in the context for improving the utilization of the waste. Normally, this is a traditional method are using by the help of bullock cart. Such kinds of biomass available in the field, like a cotton stack, has been uprooted by the help of this. This is metallic device which is also called as chimta. The traditional picking of the crop farm field is also time consuming work. Hence, the productivity is stated simply as a rate of crop picking per hour is less. The induced idea of the mechanization will be helpful to increasing the farm productivity. By this method, due to this reason, such kinds of hassles are the operators and workers are face this problem. The cost of the machine is another important parameter for using the machine. The cost, generally those machines are available in the market, which is the range of 40 lakh to 75 lakhs. In India, due to small land acquisition and fragmentation field, such kinds of huge capacity of machine are not suitable for our country. As well as due to the heavy machines, the compaction is increased. Next. Due to big size and the weight of the machine compaction, the field take place. This machine require more space and belong to heavy duty 50 to 75 HP tractor groups. Next. The objective of this study, to design and develop disintegrator suitable to cut crop residue in small pieces, to study the performance of cutter blade on mobile crop residue disintegrator for the optimization, to design and develop a mobile crop residue disintegrator and test its performance under the field conditions. The literature review, a massive literature review regarding to this work are carried out. A literature review reveals that the substantial amount of work on the crop residue management machinery has been undertaken in the past. However, the little attention has been paid on the development of crop residue disintegrator device. Significant amount of work has been done on the different aspect of crop residue management and cutting crop residue for utilization of various productive work. In India, some work has been reported on the bioresource management. Basically, we have categorized the literature review work in this 6 pattern: machines developed for crop residue management, cutter and blade design, performance evaluation criteria, cotton and forage harvester machine working and energy requirement, crop residue management and design of experiment and RSM method, response substance method. In the literature review, this is an important patent by Gemini and Dalmia on 1996 was granted patent by the United States for this flail type brush for the wood cutting machines. In this design, our one independent parameter is the blade angle. In this patent is mentioned the blade angle, the flail blade are chisel shape and have an angle other than 90 degree. Is a 90 degree and is more than 90 degree. So that's reason we have selected a proper range for the cutting of a cotton stack. Based on the conclusion from the earlier works, experiment finding and design consideration of the proposed portable disintegrator with the following features may be found applicable in the Indian condition. The proposed machine cutting speed for the cotton stack should be in between 1800 to 2000 RPM. The cutting velocity required to cut the crop residue is 25 to 70 meter per second. Cutting force required to cut cotton stack is directly proportional to the torque required of the cutter shaft as per the Chancellor book. Cutting efficiency of the crop residue machine is expected to remain more than 95% for the most of the crop. And BBD, Box-Bacon method, is an appropriate statistical tool for modeling and simulation of the investigation undertaken here. The cutting action, the basic cutting action is the cutting process in the all cases initiate when the edge of the continued motion of the knife comes in contact with the stack. A trace pattern is built up the inside material or steam until the failure condition is reached. This may be over the material or steam, even the some cases over the entire section. And the cutting action is thus scattered from the point of progress over the entire width of steam. This is the final scene. Successive step in cutting process. The cutting process in all cases initiated when the edge of the continued motion of the knife come in contact with the stack. A trace pattern is built up inside the material or steam. This may be over the material or steam, even some case over the entire sections. Next. The force on the plant steam in impactor. Basically, this machine is designed on the impact load, cutting of the impact load. The minimum knife velocity is calculated on the basis of following simplified assumption. The time for cut is the time for knife traveling distance equal to the steam diameter. The mass of the plant about the cut and accelerated uniformly to the knife velocity. The cutting force is constant during the cut. Next. Basic concept of cutting and cutting forces on the material. The total energy for the cutting and acceleration is approximately constant within the tested range of speed 43 to 84 meter per second. For the low bending strength and small mass of forest grasses require a high knife velocity for the impact cutting. The required velocity may actually vary between 25 to 70 meter per second. For reliable impact cut, least 45 meter per second velocity is required for proper cutting as found in the earlier test. Next. This is the conceptual design of the machine. Before starting any design, we have generated this conceptual model. In the conceptual model, this is the tire, this tractor PTO, the drum, it means unit number 1. This, we have categorized this machine in the 3 parts. One is the unit number 1 is drum and cutting lifting units. Another one is a crushing unit, this is a lifted cutter, cotton stack converted into small chip forms and powder forms. Then after conversion of this small chip forms are forwarded to the conveying through this blower in container or gunny bags. The various parts of this machine are shown here. Next. The details of the component. The main cutting drum. The main cutting drum consists of a flail type blade on this high speed rotor operating at least 25 to 70 meter per second of the peripheral speed as needed for getting proper cut and grasp of the crop residue. Next unit is crushing unit. This unit is the main part of the machine. The collected cotton stack is crushed and converted into powder form. This is done by the cutter mounted on the periphery. The crushing rate gets governed by the peripheral velocity. Blower unit. The blower unit is provided to throw the powder form of the residue to the collector. The periphery focus is on the synchronization of the crushing and blower unit. Hence, blower speed governs its selection. The speed of the main shaft of cutter unit selected as 2160 rpm. The speed is selected to achieve the effective cutting, which according to the earlier study should remain between 51 to 76 meter per second. The 2160 rpm of the main cutter shaft was obtained in the two step, namely by introducing V-bell drive between the two shafts. For the proposed machine, 450 mm drum diameter has been selected for the surface velocity of 42.50 meter per second by observing standard design process. The velocity lies between 25 to 73 meter per second for such kinds of machines. The total distribution of the unit wise are given here. The lifting and cutting unit have required 4.5 HP power. Crushing unit have required 5 HP power. Blower unit or conveying unit have required 2 HP power. Total power requirement for the entire operation is 11.5 HP. It is calculated by the normal design process. From the above power required to operate the machine is estimated 11.5 HP. It is assumed that the PTO shaft 80% of the engine HP is available in the machine. The developed machine is suitable for the tractor with 18 to 24 HP power, small tractors. The power transmission system of the mobile disintegrator machines are as given. This is a PTO power, 540 is a normal powers. By adding a gearbox, we have obtained 308 RPM. By adding a 13 inches pulley, it is step up to 667. Then by adding a 6 inches pulley on the counter shaft, by the help of 2.11 gear ratio, we are obtaining the RPM of 200. It means previously our design 2160 RPM decided, we have obtained here 2000 RPM. In the main crushing part, the cutting speed is less as well as the torque required for the crush the material is high. So that's reason the RPM of the machine is kept near about 100 or 1100. The main after crushing shaft, the blower by the help of 6 inches pulleys, again this step up by the help of 3 inches pulleys, we are obtaining power at the last end is 2224 for the blowing of the chip material or powder material in the bags. Next, this is a CAD model of this machine and this is a actual prototype of the machine. This is the attachment of machine with the small tractor of Mitsubishi 18.5 HP, where it's the top links had been attached and it's a gearbox. is a unit number 1 cutting and lifting by this hopper material enter in this field. Is a second unit is also called as crushing unit. After crushing this material by the help of blower are forwarded in these bags. Machine component is a flail type blade. Another one is a main cutter shaft. The actual photo of the crushing unit shaft. We are introducing first time the such kinds of triangular cutter blade because the most of the cases the stationary blade are used in the crushing crushing area. So that's why the stack are not properly cut. So that's the reason we are providing such kinds of triangular cutter with the edge of this edge. This cutter blade has fitted in this shaft. Around 16 cutter bed with the 32 edges are used for the crush the cotton stack. The trajectory of the of this machine, it's a interesting and more important part of this machine because we are adjusting the trajectory of this machine as a spiral. So that's reason only one blade at a time contact with the cotton stack. So that's reason the power required to cut of the cotton stack is less. The rotary torque measurement telemetric system. This system are generally used for the live torque of the machine at the time of testing. So in previous case I have said the torque is directly proportional to cutting force. And this is another machine where impact load testing device we are using a status the cotton stack by the help of this machine and recorded by this system. The designator was fabricated as per the dimension using mild steel sheets, angles and plates with the standard nuts, bolts, screw and welded joint. All precautions were taken to ensure alignment and trouble-free performance. The design ensured least maintenance and easy serviceability. Field trials show that the disintegrator machine cut the cotton stack satisfactorily as was expected before design. The extensive trial were planned for the experimental study relating to the cutting and collection efficiency of the machine. Simulation. CAD simulation helped the designer in knowing the kinematic assembly performance of the product before actually making the prototype and identify the modification needed. This has been done in the present case. In the cutting unit, cotton stack has cut and through this hopper are enter in this crushing unit. After crushing unit, it pass through the blowing unit and by the help of high speed blower, this material is been cut collected in the gunny bag. Design of experiment. The effect of various parameter was considered for development of a mobile disintegrator machine. The parameter combined are flail type blade, rotating speed of cutting drum and diameter of cotton stack while force acting on blade, cutting efficiency and collection efficiency are the dependent variable. The experimental design was applied after selection of the ranges. 17 experiments were required for the completion of randomized design. With 3 variables of 2 levels of each variable and 3 replications. In the present study, 27 trials were carried out on the different plot size. The range of independent variable. For the design of experiment, we have selected factorization method for the box Bergmann BBD method. In the BBD method, the minimum experiment is required for obtaining the optimized solutions. So that's reason in this experiment we have required 17 experiment. It means 15 original and 2 is replications of the medium range. Blade angle is 100 to 110. It is coded by X1. This is a lower range 100. Medium range is 105. Higher level is 110. Interval is 0.5. Impact load 10 to 30 newtons. It is coded by X2. This is the lower level is 10 newton, median level is 20 and higher level is 30, interval is 10, rotational speed in RPM 1600 to 2000 is coded by X3, X1 is a lower length, is median range and is a higher end with interval of 200. The actual value of the variable at given coded level are calculated as below. Next. The treatment combination for design of experiment by the help of BBD matrix. In the treatment combination, the total 17 experiment selected for the optimizations with various runs. In run number 1, X1 is a lower, X2 is a lower, and X3 is a median. It means 100 degree angle with a 10 Newton load with along with 1800 RPM. Next is a 10, next is a 9 or 10. It means 11th run is 0. It means median. X2 is minus means low, and X3 is minus means low. It means 105 degree angle with a 10 Newton load with a 1600 RPM is coded by the help of this software. Treatment combination for design of experiment. The experiment of cutting blade were conducted as per the randomized design with the response surface modeling. RSM of the experimental data was done using the commercial statistics software Design Expert 10.0.2. The following second order polynomial response surface model was fitted to each of the response variable with the independent variable. The independent variable. In this proposed design, proposed machine, we have selected three independent variable. That means blade angle, I previously discussed this angle, impact load for the cutting of the cotton stack, it's a play very important role, and rotating speed. Another one, the performance criteria are the dependent variable are actual load, cutting efficiency, and collection efficiency. The planning of experiment. The experiment were planned as under. Firstly, select the plot size on which trial are planned to be conducted. The feet, the blade of 100 on the rotating drum, to check the diesel level before starting testing of the machine, to measure the moisture content and take diameter of cotton stack before testing, the conducting trial at different RPM on different moisture content, repeated above procedure for 105 degree and 110 degree blade angle. After collection of all data to present in the systematic order for the analysis and optimization of design by the BBD method. The testing of crop residue mobile disintegrator. The procedure adopted for the testing of crop residue mobile disintegrator machine is given below. The experiment test plot was 25 meter by 25 meter. His observation was replicated, taken three times. Is already this this testing 27 testing multiplied by 3 is mean this all data is available in the annexures. According to CRD, firstly select a different plot of different cotton variety with a different moisture content. Using vernier caliper, determine the diameter of the cotton stack randomly in the selected field. Measure height of the plant with a measuring tape. Also measure the plot size by 25 meter by 25 meter. In the selected plot, take a sample of cotton stack for the measurement of moisture content in the specific plot. Prepare various size of blade with a different angle, 100 degree, 100, 105 and 100, 110 degree. All selected blade are fitted to the rotating drum for the testing. The torque measurement equipment is fitted between the gearbox and PTO. Fuel level indicator is used to check the fuel level before starting. The tractor speed are adjusted according to field requirement. After checking of all necessary arrangement, machine is ready for the first trials, and the speed of field trial was kept 1600 to 600 for the first blade angle, that is 100 degree. After starting first trial, the live torque pickup are noted. The real speed of the machine is noted down at time required to cover a 25 meter distance was recorded. In the completion of the first trial, the time and cutting speed was recorded beside level of fuel after trial. Number of plant cut was also noted to determine the cutting efficiency. It's a dependent variable. The collected crop residue in the bag was collected, and marked weight was determined using electronic weighing scale for determination of the actual collection efficiency of the machines. In the next set of the trial speed, 1800 RPM, the procedure is repeated, and similar procedure is followed for the 2000 RPM. The measurement response. The effect of various parameters for the development of the mobile disintegrator, like types of blade, impact load, cutting speed, torque power, actual impact load, cutting efficiency, collection efficiency, sample size, were directly lost and stored in the computer system. First is the cutting force on blade. The in the actual field testing, the torque measurement equipment was attached between the gearbox and the PTO shaft. On this testing, the value of torque was noted down. According to Chancellor, the torque is directly proportional to the force, so actual force are calculated by this method. Because the actual force at the time of cutting is not possible to count it. The measurement next is the cutting efficiency. Actual machine performance on the field is decided by cutting efficiency. At the time of testing, number of plant in the chosen plot are counted. Also performing trial on the plot in same row, number of untouched plant are counted. Next is the collection efficiency. Another parameter to determine the actual performance of the machine was collection efficiency. In the selected plot, particular row was shortlisted according to normal statistical method. Theoretical weight of the plant are calculated by the material density in one row. It means we have collected in the different plant, we have selected 5 to 6 plant and it is uprooted and check this weight by theoretical way. After cutting of this, after cutting process, we have counted all materials in the bag by the help of weighing scales. It is the ratio of weight of collected material in attached bag to the actual weight of one row. PFT, prototype field testing. Before conducting a field trial, following factors are considered. One is the testing plot area, row distance, plant spacing, number of plant in 1 hectare, theoretical plant in 1 meter by 1 meter area, actual plant in 1 meter by 1 meter area, moisture content, diameter of cotton stack, height of plant and weight of plant. At the field testing, following points should be taken into account. Actual field efficiency of the machine, actual efficiency of machine, cutting efficiency of machine, maximum and minimum speed of the cutting, field area cover in 1 hour for the determination of average of the machine and cost of harvesting, fuel requirement for 1 hectare and to determine actual speed of machine on the field. Collection of field data before testing. By the help of vernier caliper, we have determined the diameter of the cotton stack directly from the field. Next, distance between two plants. It measured by the help of measuring tape. The number of previous plant. The number of plant in 1 meter are counted. Next, the height of plant is also counted and plant density will be also counted by the selected plant area. The detail of the plot for the testing of the trial, we have selected name of variety of the cotton is irrigated PT cotton. Plot area is 50 meter by 50 meter. Row and plant spacing, row spacing between distance between the two row and plant spacing distance between the two plants. This is a irrigated cotton variety, so that's reason the canopy of the plant is so high. So that's reason number of plant is so less, is around 9300 plants. Theoretical plant in 2 meter by 2 meter is 6 plant. Actual counted 5 to 6 plant were observed. The moisture content of this plot is 32.76 by average. These all value has been counted by the help of previous methods. Next. After conducting the trial, collected sample in the bag are shown. We have already pick up some sample from the area, cutting area. Next. Measurement of weight. After collection of the all chip form material in the gunny bag, we have counted by the help of weighing scale at Dr. Punjab Pradesh Kushidya Bit Akola. Next, we have measured the dimensions of the cutting chips or collected chip in the gunny bags. This is the sample of the collected crop residue in the bag. Next, another sample according to size. Next, the sampling. By determination of actual sizes, we have carried out this process. By after sampling, such kinds of various size of crop residue are collected and measured by the help of weighing scale. With complete distribution of collected stock in 1 kg sample in 3 trial, it is observed that in this case 0 to 25 mm maximum material is around 40.56. Next, distribution of crop residue in 1 kg. Next. The actual photo of using 105 degree blade fitted on the cutter drum. After cutting or obtain the actual photo of the cotton stack from field. The photo of agronomy plot. Dr. Punjab Rao Deshmukh Kushidev Dakula, this is the irrigated cotton variety. The trial photo, the trial field trial on agronomy plot. After cutting, after field trial, photo of agronomy plot are shown in the figure. Canopy of the field is so high and moisture content is so high. The Dr. Vanjari is a dean of agronomy field, Dr. Punjab Rao Kushidev Dakura, associate dean Dr. Walde. The senior research engineer, cotton field. Next. After cutting off one row, for the determination of optimized value with the direct three trials, conducting three trials, the details are given in the average value are given in this field. Next, for our point of view, field efficiency is 91.44, cutting efficiency, average cutting efficiency is observed at 96.17. Average collection efficiency is 78.75 and cost of operations per hour and per hectare is shown in 900 as well as 126 rupees. Result and discussion. The next part is the field parameter of the cotton stack is to verify the performance of the machine blade on the field crop residue. Trial were conducted according to design of experiment in the selected plot of size 20 meter by 20 meter size. The parameter considered were the cotton plant diameter, height of plant, distance between two plant, row spacing, moisture content and plant density. Performance evaluation of crop residue mobile disindicator. The field tests were conducted with the range of moisture content 31.16% to 34.18%. The cotton stack density represents the wider range of crop residue that was usually encountered in the field of conditions. Various size of cotton stack were available in the plot while conducting the trial, but maximum size was observed 20.12 meter. Normally in the Vidarbha region, the cotton stack diameter is around 12 mm to 18 mm. But this plot is an irrigated plot, so that's reason the diameter of the cotton stack is increased. In the observation, it is observed that maximum diameter of the cotton stack is 28 mm. The various parameters obtained under the design treatment combination during the trial. After conduction of the trial, 27 trial, according to BBD matrix, were fitted all given data according to levels in this table. This actual force, cutting efficiency, collection efficiency, speed, impact load and blade angle. Total 17 trials data are fitted in this BBD matrix for obtaining the optimized solutions. Effect of various independent variable on actual cutting force. The actual cutting force required by the different blade angle is 100 degree, 105 and 110 for the crop residue threading were recorded for all three different cutting speed 1600, 1800 and 2000. It is observed that there is a significant variation in the impact load with the change in speed, cutting force and blade angle. The impact load increased linearly with increased speed and blade angle while the increased quadratically with the impact load in case of all blade. With increased speed from 1600 to 2000 rpm, Actual fold decrease for all the three cutting blade angle from 100 degree to 110 degree. Cutting fold decrease up to 105 degree cutting blade angle. Increase was small when the cutting angle was increased up to 110. Next. The ANOVA. ANOVA table showing the effect of variable actual cutting force and coefficient of predictive model for the crop cutting. In the ANOVA, it is observed that the model 1 is pretty significant for this F value. The R square value is 0.94, adjusted R square 0.886, and lack of fit is 0.12, it is not significant. It means this value is fitted for the next. The equation of determination of cutting force in terms of actual factor. The actual by adding this value in the software, after performing the operations, BBD matrix have provided these equations. In this equation, x1, x2, x3 is the independent variable, that is the blade angle, impact load and cutting speed. The effect of blade angle of cutting force, actual force in Newton for the cotton stack diameter 20 mm, cutting speed and the blade angle range and the impact load. This all value are shown by surface contour. Next, this is the surface contour for 1600 RPM. By the help of design expert software, we have generated this solution. This is the surface contour and this is the contour of this all image. For the 1800 RPM, it is also observed that the cutting force required for cut the cotton stack is low. Similarly, for the 200 RPM, it is again show that the cutting force required for cut the cotton stack is low. Effect of various independent variable on the cutting efficiency is our another dependent variable. Cutting efficiency defined earlier is an important performance on the field. In simple language, the cutting efficiency is the ratio of total number of plant before cutting to number of plant after cutting. During testing, number of plant are counted before and after in the same row cutting operations. And now showing the effect of variable on cutting efficiency and coefficient of predictive model for the mobile disindicator. Next. The R square value was calculated by the least square technique and found to be 0.97, showing the good fit of the model to the data. And the model F value is implies that model is significant. The rotating speed, blade angle and load quadratic term like blade angle with a 20 Newton load are significant. The lack of fit F value was not significant, which is indicated that the developed model was adequate for the predicting the response. Moreover, the model adequacy evaluated by predicted R square 0.96 show it to be in reasonable agreement with the adjusted R square 0.92. This is the ANOVA table showing the effect of variable on the cutting efficiency and coefficient of predictive model. Similarly, for this model, 0.003 is a significant value. Lack of fit is 0.018 is non-significant. R square is 0.96 and adjusted R square is 0.92. The R square value, next. The relationship between cutting efficiency and effecting parameter. The equation in terms of actual factor can be used to make the prediction about the response. For the given level of each factor, the regression equation show similarly in this equation x1, x2, x3 is the blade angle, impact load and cutting speed. Effect of blade angle on cutting efficiency. The average cotton stack diameter observed at 20 mm at the height of 5 cm from the ground surface, because in the Vidarbha region maximum percent of stone are available, so that's why the chances of damage of the blade of our machine, so that's reason we have counted this machine is set the performing cutting action before 5 cm, more than 5 cm of the ground level. The experiment trial were conducted at a various cutting speed at 1600, 1800, 2000 RPM. The detailed experimental value of resulting efficiency on different speed was recorded and given in the table. Similarly, for the previous section, this cutting efficiency for the all blade angle and with all impact load are shown in the surface plot. Next, the surface plot is the highest cutting efficiency for the 20 newtons and 105 blade angle for the 1600 RPM. Next. Similarly, for the 1800 RPM, it is observed higher value. Similarly, for the 20,000 RPM, it is obtained the higher value. It means more than 98.30 is the highest value for this plot and 93.12 is the lowest value of this plot. The last effect of last is the effect of various independent variable on collection efficiency. In the field testing, performance of the machine was evaluated in terms of collection efficiency. It is the ratio of weight of collected material in attached bag to actual weight of one row. It was found that the trouble-free performance of satisfactory level is attainable only if the material is cut in 18 to 22% moisture content range. The collection efficiency of the mobile disintegrator was calculated by the collecting the crop residue in the gunny bag and using weighing scale. The ANOVA table showing the effect of variable on cutting efficiency and coefficient of predictive model. Similarly, this model is significant with a 0.004 and lack of feed is 0.065, not significant. The R square is 0.92 and adjusted R square is 0.82. The model F value is 13.65, implies that the model is significant for the variable blade angle, impact load and cutting speed. The lack of feed F value was not significant, which indicated that the developed model was adequate for the predicting the response. Moreover, the model adequacy evaluated with the R square 0.92, it to be in reasonable agreement with the adjusted R square 0.82. This indicates that the non-significant term have not been included in the model. Therefore, this model could be used to navigate the design space. Relationship of collection efficiency in terms of design. Similarly, after performing the operations, get equations in another way, in this equation x1, x2 and x3 is an independent variable, that is the blade angle, impact load and the cutting speed. Effect of blade angle on the collection efficiency. The trial of mobile disintegrator machine were conducted to determine the collection efficiency of machine with the cut the crop residue. The experimental trial were conducted in at cutting speed of 1600, 1800 and 2000 RPM. The detailed experimental value are given in the next table. Collection efficiency. In this collection efficiency, it is observed that the maximum collection efficiency 80.85 for the 105 blade angle at 800 RPM. Similarly, for the impact load of 20 Newton, highest collection efficiency is 81.35 with 1800 RPM. From this figure, it is observed that the cutting speed of 600 to 2000 RPM, all types of blade angle, the collection efficiency was observed 74.80% to 80.85%. Similarly, the cutting efficiency was in the range of 74.95 to 81.35. It is observed that the higher cutting velocity material is spread on the field. Collection efficiency is therefore less. At low speed, the material was not lifted forcefully. It is observed that 1800 to 2000 RPM is better for such kinds of machine. Similarly, the surface plot are given. In the surface plot, the higher cutting collection efficiency is 73.80, denoted by this color, and lower efficiency, sorry. Higher efficiency is 82.08%, it is denoted by red color. This plot for the 1600 RPM. This plot for the 1800 RPM, it is also similar, it shows that cutting efficiency is higher at these two points. And this is the last, is the 2000 RPM, on the maximum collection efficiency are shown by this surface plot. Optimization of design parameter. Numerical and graphical optimization was carried out for the independent design parameter of the mobile disintegrator. Machine to be obtained the optimum blade angle with the minimum cutting force requirement so as to yield maximum cutting efficiency and collection efficiency. Design expert software was used to simultaneously optimization of the multiple response. Optimization criteria. The blade angle, impact load, speed, actual force, cutting efficiency and collection efficiency. The goal is 105 is our target value. Lower limit is 110. Upper limit is 100. Upper limit is 110. Weight, lower weight is 1. Upper weight is 1 and importance is 3. Similarly, the all size importance is 3. Lower weight is 1. For the impact load, target is 20 Newton, lower limit is 10 Newton, upper limit is 30 Newton. Similarly, for this speed, 1800 is our target, lower limit is 1600 and upper limit is 2000. Actual force, this entire cutting process, we have required actual force is minimized because the force is minimized, automatically the power requirement for the cut of the material is minimized. So, the fuel requirement for the cutting action is also minimized. Cutting efficiency is maximized and collection efficiency is maximized. Solution generated by the software for the optimum condition for the response. After conducting of the several trial and feeding this data in the box Bayman method BBD matrix, after generations of the after carried out the statistical process, we are obtaining 113 solutions. Out of 113 solution, this is the best solution. That is 98.07 is the cutting efficiency with the actual force of 9.2 Newton and collection efficiency at 81.91 with the desirability of 0.92. For the blade angle 105, impact load 20 Newton and speed is 1800. This is the circle superimposed contour for the all values. This is the area shows the solutions. Desired solution in 113 solution we have obtained. Next is another is impact load versus speed. At this point is the optimum point where 81.91 is the collection efficiency, cutting efficiency is 98.07, actual force is 9.20 and the range is 20 Newton force with the 1800 cutting speed. Is the desirability, this area showed the desirability of desirability point 0.9.2. Actual cutting force, the predicted value is 9.2. The cutting efficiency, this area show the cutting efficiency, the predicted value is this, is 98.09 and the collection efficiency is, this point show the 81.11. The superimposed contour of all response for the blade angle and impact load for rotational speed and there is intersection zone for the minimum actual force are shown. Maximum cutting efficiency and maximum collection efficiency indicate the ranges of variable which could be considered as the optimum range for the best for crop residue mobile disintegrator machine. The range of optimum value of independent variable obtained from the superimposed contour are cutting force is 9.2, cutting efficiency is 98.07, collection efficiency is 81.11. FE analysis, after performance of the optimized statistical method in the BBD matrix, we know the 105 is the best angle for the 1800 RPM for this field. So we have checked our design by the help of FE software. Finite element analysis was performed to test the distribution of traces and deformation in the optimized blade, which was subjected to external load. FE enabled one to quickly spot problem areas and redesigning the product without the costly rework and refabrication, the saving time and money. For the purpose of finite element analysis, the one message trace failure criteria was used with a specifically test the trace at which the material began to yield. The cutting blade used was of a heat treated steel. The first analysis, these are main generations of the 100 degree blade. Next. Total deformation, this total deformation shows value is 1.50 is the minimum value for this 100 degree blade. And next, equivalent traces, the equivalent traces show that 8.539 times power 5 Pascal is the minimum and equivalent trace developed is 6.083 times power 5 Pascal, these values. Shear trace, this is shear trace is 2.52 into 10 to the power 5 for the 100 degree blade angle. They show in the red points, this is the red points. Next, PM analysis for the 105 blade angle. In this 105 blade angle, after main generation, the number of node is 1594 with a number of element of 482. The total deformation observed at 5.12 into 10 to the power minus 6. equivalent race. This equivalent race is also noted maximum for 1.03 5.10^6 Pascal and minimum is 0.5228 Pascal. Shear trace is a very important parameter for validation of design. That shear trace developed in the blade was recorded. It is maximum 84.940 Pascal and minimum -1.226 × 10^5 Pascal. In this case, minimum edge, the maximum trace is developed at the back side of the bending blade here at this point. Next. FM analysis of 110 blade. After mesh generation, number of node is 1604, number of element is 486. Total deformation, by observing total deformation value 2.61 × 10^-7 meter. Next, the equivalent traces, the minimum equivalent trace is 52208 Pascal for the 110 blade. Shear trace, the final analysis done was for the shear trace. The shear trace developed in the blade was recorded. It is maximum 89925 Pascal and minimum -1.1304 × 10^5 Pascal. Next. After analysis, it is observed that the 105 degree blade angle on the 1800 RPM, it is suitable or best solution. The comparison between the predicted and actual response variable at optimum condition mobile disintegrator machine. After performing the three trial, the average value are noted here. 8.81 Newton is actual value, 96.17 is actual efficiency, and 78.75 is the actual collection efficiency on the plot. The predicted value is 92.9.2 Newton, cutting efficiency is 98.02%, and collection efficiency is 81.11. It means percentage error, it is observed that is less than 4%, and variations are shown is 2.9 is high. Next, conducting field test in the cotton research station plot at Dr. Panjarao Deshmukh Krishi Vidyapeeth Akola. The optimized mobile disintegrator machine with a blade angle of 105 degree was attached to the shaft of tractor. The machine was operated with the help of tractor PTO at rated RPM to obtain the optimized speed 1800 RPM. The speed of tractor was kept in the range of 2.5 to 2.8 km per hour for the trial. The details of the observation and related data are given in the given annexures. After comparison with the predicted data with actual value, it is noted that for the most of the observation, the variation is between 1 to 3%. Next. Conclusion. Principal finding. The main objective of the research work was to develop a suitable tractor-operated crop residue disintegrator and study the performance of the machine under field conditions. The machine was built and tested for the evaluation performance for operating condition. The various reviews were taken to in account in the development process. The power source was an important factor since small tractor of 15 to 18 HP were popular amongst the farmer. The disintegrator was developed as an attachment for a commonly available 18 HP tractor. Conceptual model of mobile disintegrator machine was developed using the Autotex Inventor software and analyzed for various force acting on it. It was observed that the highest value of one mesh traces for the blade is 13.09 MPa and translation displacement magnitude is 0.115 mm. The yield strength of the maestries is 2200 MPa. This resulted in factor of safety 15.27, which is very high and therefore safe. Various parts have been developed and selected as a broad out atom during the development process. Optimization of design, the cutting blade angle with a different speed and load play a better role. Next. For this analysis was done using the selected combination of the blade angle, impact load and cutting speed. The performance criteria were actual force, cutting efficiency and collection efficiency. The factorial box wagon design matrices method was selected for the optimization solution of the blade angle. A total of 17 runs with a 3 variable were conducted. Analysis show optimization solution of the blade angle 105 degree with an impact load of 20 Newton at a speed of 1800 RPM. The optimized blade design was adopted for the final prototype development. total weight of the machine was 180 kg. It can be easily attached to the 3-point linkage system of the small tractor. The fabrication cost of the first prototype was ₹51,200. The average cost of the operation of the machine was ₹820 per hectare, which is affordable to the small and marginal farmer. The effect of impact load, blade angle and speed on the cutting efficiency and collection efficiency and actual force required was evaluated. The relationship between impact load, blade angle, speed on cutting, collection efficiency, actual force required was developed. It is now possible to predict their value for a given parametric variable. The R square value in all cases are nearer to 0.9 and are acceptable. The equation can be used to determine the impact of the blade angle and speed on cutting and collection efficiency and actual forces at rated RPM. This is all equation I previously discussed. The use of Design Expert 10.0.2 software for the experimental design with the factorial box bacon design matrix method was found suitable for finding optimized solution of the blade angle. The optimized solution of the blade angle is 105 degree with an impact load of 20 Newton at a speed of 1800 RPM. The average field capacity of the crop residue mobile disintegrator in the cotton crop was observed at 0.36 hectare per hour. This all calculation are available in the annexures. This was satisfactorily as the machine has been developed for the small land holding only. The cutting efficiency, collection efficiency, cutting force of the machine in larger scale trial was 96.17 and 78.75 and 80.73 Newton respectively. Variation between 1 to 4% of the optimized performance level were observed. From this, it is concluded that the optimized blade is suitable for the prototype developed in the work. It is concluded that the peripheral speed of the bitter is suitable for the disintegration of the cotton, pigeon pea and sorghum crop residue, and the transmission system is suitable for providing effective transmission of power available in PTO unit of tractor. The fixed clearance between the bitter and the fail type knife did not affect the variation in the total output and particle size of the disintegrated material with respect to the change of the screen. From the study, it is concluded that the machine is suitable for the clean development mechanism since it is utilized the biomass of reducing the greenhouse gases, burning of crop residue in the field by the farms it is avoided. It is opined based on the trial run that utilization of such kind of machine will prove as an income generation source to farmers, provide for the proper utilization of biomass, increases employment in the rural sector and development small scale industry based on the biomass resource. Scope of the future work. It is suggested that the machine be provided with an additional facility in the form of autoloader. The loading the object automatically would make work easier and save the energy of worker. The machine is equipped with a sensor to indicate that the container is full and get switch off under no load condition. Blade design can be improved further in terms of material configuration and geometry for the more efficient cutting, thereby reduce fuel consumption and better overall performance may be achieved. These are reference, refer 7 patents for these machines. The websites, various websites of the Terry's Berry and Irida, Sircott, Berry. Publication related to research work. International Journal, Design and Optimization of Mobile Crop Residue Disintegrator by using Box Bacon RSM method. Next one is a Modeling and Optimization of Mobile Crop Residue Disintegrator. Another one is Development and Performance of Evaluation of Crop Residue Mobile Disintegrator. Next one is fourth paper is a study of crop residue machine for conversion of biomass into chip form. International Conference, the study of various crop residue machinery for conversion of biomass into powder and chip form are delivered in the International Conference at GHRCE Nagpur. The World Congress IPCOM 2015, this paper is accepted but due to some technical problem we could not represent this paper at Taipei. Next, patent publication on research work. We have filed patent before starting of our work. Next, the final patent notification in IPR General In January 2016, our patent are published in the IPR with the journal number as 01206. Thank you.
Based on the writer given to me.
Okay.
So, in my overall comments, so I'll just give you an overview of how a PhD work is evaluated and what is looked for in a PhD work. So, in a PhD work, a few things are essential. The first thing which an evaluator will look for is whether the work has some importance, whether the work is important enough. Now, if it is a theoretical work, it would have a different meaning of importance. In your case, it's a completely application-oriented work. So, in your case, importance would mean whether the problem you are addressing is important enough. Second thing which would be looked at is whether the study you are conducting has gone into enough depth in the field or not.
Okay.
Third is whether you have come up with a finding which is novel in some sense, something which could not have been predicted earlier. That is the third thing. And fourth is the manner in which the work has been reported.
Okay.
That is the report which you have finally submitted. So I will go through each of them one by one. So in the first count, your work has applicability which cannot be surpassed, particularly in the Indian context. Nobody can claim that this work is not important. So your work on that particular count, your work passes with flying colors. The second one was whether you have gone into sufficient depth or not, whether enough work has been done. On that count also, I would say that the sheer volume of work that you are reporting is very, very high. There is no problem about that at all. The third count, which is there on coming up with a result which can be called novel in some sense, that is being able to report something which people could not have predicted just by common sense. So that kind of thing, that might be there somewhere in some of your findings, but you have not clearly brought it out in your conclusions part. So maybe you can give a little thought to it, that which one amongst your last set of results is something which you can call novel. Novel in the sense that you have found out something after a lot of experiments and a lot of analysis. This is something which people would not have predicted automatically. It was not coming out in people's mind as a matter of course. So maybe you can highlight that particular point, that this is my major finding from my PhD work. And the last thing is the way in which the work has been reported. Now, I did not have the chance to go through your thesis because I did not have a copy of it. I had only a shortened version of it, this extended abstract of it. So if you allow me, I'll make a few comments on what you have reported in the extended abstract.
Oh.
Is that fine?
Okay.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So it's, I'll start off with some things which you may have already taken care of in your final thesis, but at least in the abstract they were not there. For example, I am sure in your actual thesis you have referred to each one of these references in the literature review chapter, but obviously in the abstract that particular chapter was very short, so it was only one page. No. Right? And do you, agree with me? Do you agree with me?
Yes.
That because your literature review was shortened to just one page in the abstract, so those references which you have mentioned, they are not here at all. So I hope all of them have been mentioned in your thesis.
Yeah.
Okay. So you have to take care of that. At the same time, in the very first page, I found one reference, Nagmani et al. 1995, that does not appear in the list of references at all. So just make sure that such errors don't occur when you write your final thesis. Basic things about making such reports. I guess the figure 3.1 and the few subsequent figures, they are not drawn by you, right?
No, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
They are not drawn by you.
Generated by this.
No. Absolutely. It's okay. Please let me finish. So, when you are taking figures which have been given somewhere else and you are putting it in your report,
yes, sir.
It is essential to give the reference over here.
Okay.
So,
yes.
You have to undo that. You have
yes.
to be careful about this.
Yes.
Then again, maybe in your thesis we have gone into it in more detail, but in the conceptual drawing which you have given over here,
yes.
there are a lot of numbers. You have named the parts as 1, 2, 3, 4, going right up to 19.
20, yes.
Yeah. So, when I read the description, I don't see those numbers anyway. You have to refer back to those numbers when you are giving the description of this. A few things within that description itself. You are saying, for example, power required to drive this part of the unit has been estimated, and you also gave some tables over there.
Yes, sir.
Power required for this subsection is
yes,
so
sir.
Much. Power required for that subsection is so much. And then you have also said, considering various losses, this works out to be 18.5 horsepower.
Yes.
So, you have to give some basis for coming up with those numbers.
Okay.
When you are stating that the power required for this subsection is so and so, some basis has to be there. Either based on some subpart related manufacturer specifications which are given, or based on some other estimate, something, some basis has to be there instead of just quoting one number. Again, some editorial kind of points. So over here, for example, when you mention the conceptual drawing showing various functional parts is presenting in a figure, you must always mention the figure number, the figure number so and so. It should not be mentioned in the following figure or has been mentioned in a figure. You must not do that. So again, maybe you have already taken care of many of these in your thesis. I have not had the chance to go through it. But please make sure that these are done. I am coming to the fourth chapter, Design of Experiments. So in many places you have made a mistake of this fail type
fail.
F-L-A-I-L.
Yes,
so in many parts from this point onwards,
yes.
either the word processor has made a mistake or
yes.
you have made a mistake. maybe the word processor could not have recognized it and it has changed it to F-A-I-L. So it should be F-L-A-I-L.
Yes, yes.
So, yeah, now it's you have mentioned three parameters which are independent and three which are dependent, right?
Yes.
That is what you are...
Yes, sir. Previously these were shortlisted some list. As per the suggestion given by Dr. Panjab Rishmi David Akuna, Dr. I.A. Pardeshi, we have decided diameter of the cotton stack.
Okay.
Unfortunately, this cotton stack diameter is very field to field, as well as according to irrigated condition. So that's reason they was suggested. And another one is the three factor and three by three factorial method in the method. The experiment required for conduction is so less in BBD matrix.
Okay.
So that's reason three factors were decided and the another factor are.
I understand. Again, over here, I am not able to relate what you have said in this page 15 and what you have said in page 16. In page 15, you have starting to say that the parameters combined are flake type of blade, rotating speed of cutting drum, and diameter of cotton stock. These three are the independent parameters. So I mean, he has not mentioned that. That has not been mentioned. Yeah. So you, the way you are starting to write this thing, it appears that this is what we have considered for the rest. But exactly. So I mean, after reading this, one would get the feeling that these are going to be the parameters which are going to be considered from this point onwards. But actually,
ignored.
Yeah, so in this sense, because they are not controllable. Exactly, right, I understand. But that has not been explained. So again, maybe in your actual thesis, you have given a little more details about the numerical optimization. For example, you say the desired holes for each factor and response was chosen. A little more details have to be there. More details about this are needed. Again, another referencing error according to Chancellor. So again, if I see there is no reference for Chancellor 2008 in your list. If you see Chancellor, there is one Chancellor of 1958, another Chancellor without any date.
Yes, sir. 1958.
Sorry. So you have to take care of these. Yeah. Now I come to one major point. For a large part of your thesis, you are evaluating your results with the help of actual field efficiency,
yes,
actual efficiency of machine,
yes,
and cutting efficiency.
Yes.
You have to define these terms.
Sir, cutting efficiency, it means we have selected one row. In one row, 25 or 20 numbers of plant is available. After passing of the machine on this is the number of uncut plant are counted.
Very good. That is number three, cutting efficiency.
Yes, sir.
What is actual efficiency?
The actual efficiency, it means there are two kinds of efficiency. Theoretical field efficiency and another one is field efficiency. Field efficiency, it means the area covered by the machine in the given time, it will be calculated. And number of time required for to cover this area, it including productive or non-productive times.
I did not understand.
And collection efficiency, it means.
No. Wait. Can you please repeat the previous definition once again?
Actual efficiency,
yeah,
means machine actually perform in the field. There are two types, theoretical field efficiency and effective field efficiency.
No. The terms you have used here are actual field efficiency, actual efficiency of machine. These are the two terms which you have used.
Actual field efficiency, sorry.
Have you? You can look at it. These are the terms which you have used.
Yes, sir. Actual field efficiency, it means the machine width is 670 mm. We have covered this area, one strip, and if the row distance between two plant is around 60 cm, it means this area machine are covered only 1600 mm, near 300 and near 300 is left. So that's reason the area cover in given time is divided by time required.
I don't think it is coming out properly. I suggest you discuss this with your supervisor once again.
Yes.
So these three terms have to be defined properly. When you are talking about efficiency, the
most important is
collection efficiency.
I understand that.
And collection efficiency are counted, we have selected 3 to 4 plot. From this 3 to 4 plot we have uprooted cotton stack, and this cotton stack are counted by the help of the weight of the this cotton stack are counted by the help of weighing scale. After conducting trial, the material are collected in the bag is counted, and by the help of this previous data we have calculated theoretical weight of this particular row. It means the number of row, number of plant, and
I thought that would automatically come same as the cutting efficiency. It should come, but anyway there may be some reason why it is not coming. So again, you have to be a little careful about numbering of the figures. 5.123, it is 5.234. So one is actually this figure, this picture of the plant and all that. So those things you have to take care. So that's an impact load. No, so I'm just thinking of impact load and actual force. Yeah. So again, can you tell me when you are drawing these diagrams? These surface plots.
Yes.
So one axis is blade angle, which I can understand.
Yes.
One axis is impact load in Newton.
Yes.
The other axis is actual force.
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me how was this impact load evaluated and how was this actual force evaluated?
Impact load testing device testing I developed Dr. Panjara Deshmukh Kushitabeta Kula. At this point we have fit any kind of stack. By the help of this blade, here is a attached one blade, the impact load as well as torque and force is automatically calculated. But in the actual performance and actual cutting process on field, the actual force for required to cut the cotton stack is not possible to calculate it. So that's reason such kinds of rotary torque measurement element system are designed, fitted between the tractor PTO and gearbox. And this pickup value has been picked up, and it is directly proportional to actual force, as per referred by this book, Chancellor books.
I see. There would be some transmission losses also after
yes,
that.
Yes, sir.
So I hope you have taken that into consideration.
Yes.
Okay. So one is testing it in the laboratory conditions, and one is testing it on the
actual
field.
Yes, sir. Because we don't know actually.
Right. I understand. Okay, fine. in some cases you have to just make sure that the fonts are large enough. For example, in figure 5.13 of your abstract, of course, you will see that the fonts are so small that they are not visible.
Yes.
And I would say these are very important figures, because it is from these that you are coming up with the actual optimized design.
Yes.
So these, maybe you can blow up a little and explain it itself.
Snapshots.
Because after all, when you are talking of an optimization exercise, it is not with the help of an optimization algorithm, it's a graphical optimization. Yeah. So, and it, the relevant graphs are these four.
Okay.
So they have to be given due importance in your work. Same problem, we have got predicted value, actual value. What are these? I mean, it was not clear to me. Yeah, okay, I guess. Just one more thing. It is nice that we have done the finite element analysis. A little more detail again is needed. Maybe you have given it in your thesis.
Yes, this all report generated by the software is given.
Yeah, yeah. No. I am not talking of the report generated by the software. By detail, what I mean is that when a finite element simulation is done, you have to say that after constructing this part in the finite element software, this is the surface which was kept fixed.
Yes.
This is the surface or area over which force was applied, in which direction, how much of a force was applied.
Yes.
Okay, so you have to give enough details so that boundary conditions, all the boundary conditions have to be specified. So unless you do that, it will not be possible for somebody else to duplicate your work. So you have to go in, you have to go into that much detail and describe all the things which you did when running the simulation. Okay. That's it, I guess. So I'm sure you can insert and improve your thesis with these comments.
Yes.
The major one, as I see, is that just again discuss with the supervisor which is the point that you want to bring out as the major contribution, something that you can say that you have thought of for the first time, nobody else thought of it. Because you realize, I hope, that you cannot say that making a machine for this is something I thought for the first time. That people may have even thought so earlier. People may have attempted to design similar machines also earlier. So which part of the design is something that people have not thought of at all and you thought of for the first time?
Something
which is standing out. It may be a combination of two ideas which people have not thought of combining earlier. Maybe they existed on their own in different domains. You have combined them for the first time. Some that kind of idea, if you can bring out, that will be your major contribution of the thesis. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Any specific queries from the audience? PhD students and the PhD scholars, any specific queries related to the topic? If not, with this, we are extremely thankful on behalf of the institute. I am thankful to Professor Guha for being here for the very purpose of this pre-submission seminar. And we will seek your guidance in future as well, sir. And I assure on behalf of the PhD scholar that the in-depth comments which you have made, those will be incorporated in the thesis and it will be taken due care of. Thank you one and all for patient hearing.